Hi, my name is Andrew McDermott, and this is the Champions Mindset Podcast. Join me as I dive into the minds of the world's greatest champions and share with you the secrets, lessons, and knowledge that's allowed them to rise to the top. Welcome to our community of greatness, abundance, and fortitude. Thank you so much for being here. It's time to become the person you've always wanted to be. What's going on, everybody? The Champions Mindset Podcast is back with episode number 7. Today on the show, I interview Bedros Koulian, who has been a role model for me for a very long time. Bedros is the go-to guy in the fitness entrepreneur industry, and overall one of the greatest business minds I know of. He's created an international fitness empire and is one of the most coveted business coaches in the world. And he's not just an incredible entrepreneur, but an even better person. We begin the podcast by talking about Bedros' beginnings, which every time I hear leaves me speechless. It honestly sounds like something from a movie. You see, Bedros was born in communist Armenia, and his family escaped when he was just 4 years old. His family had absolutely nothing when they got to the U.S. They were dead broke and doing anything to survive, which meant digging through dumpsters just to put some food on the table. I'll let Bedros tell you the entire story, but this is where the title of this episode comes from, The Immigrant Edge. This is the type of mentality Bedros tries to instill in everyone he coaches, and the wisdom he has to share today is priceless. Talking with Bedros really put things in perspective for me, to say the least, and it'll make you realize the unbelievable opportunities we have here in the United States and other free countries. In the show, we get into how to take the first step in your path to success, the truth about how to build a world-class network, why your track record means everything in your success, and a lot of different insights from Bedros on how to build the champion's mindset. Of course, we end the show with Bedros' Champions Challenge, which was fantastic. Before we get into the interview, this episode is brought to you by First Finisher, which just released a revolutionary new sports performance supplement called Champion Total Performance Powder. This is an all-in-one daily supplement for optimal athletic performance. The goal behind Champion Total Performance Powder was to combine the world's most effective and proven supplements into one perfect formula. 9 ingredients providing you with the ultimate combination of athletic benefits, like building rock-hard muscle and powerhouse strength, burning away and keeping off fat, increasing energy and endurance, improving your mood, focus, and cognition, enhancing blood flow, increasing lean body mass, and so much more. Really, if you're looking to maximize your athletic potential and become the best you can be, your supplement routine needs to start with Champion Total Performance Powder. This formula is also free from any artificial coloring, sweeteners, and harmful fillers like you see in most sports supplements. Our podcast listeners can receive 15% off their first order by using the discount code PODCAST15. That's PODCAST15. Just head over to www.firstfinisher.com and we will hook you up. So let's get into the show then. All right, I am here with the one and only Bedros Koulian. Thank you so much for being on the show today, Bedros. It is truly an honor.
Andrew, thank you so much for having me, man. It's a pleasure.
We have a great show for you today, and we're going to get right into it. For those of you who don't know Bedros, he is a college dropout, just as I am. After he dropped out of college, he was living out of his 1979 Toyota pickup with a self-described leaky camper shell. And what happened next to Bedros? Well, he failed at launching 2 fitness businesses, lost over $55,000 in one of them in only 13 months. So most people would pack it up right then and there, right? He dropped out, took a big risk, and didn't make it, didn't work out. So it's back to school, right? Dream's dead. Well, not for Bedros. And this is where I want to start the show. Bedros, can you tell our listeners a little bit about your backstory and how you went from college dropout, failed business owner to where you are now?
Sure, sure. So the best way that I've heard someone describe me was they said, you're the American dream and the immigrant edge. And that was my videographer who's been working for me now for 7-8 years. And his name is Rob Yeager, great guy. And it was 2009, I decided to launch an international fitness franchise. My plan was to have it on every continent, if possible, and to have hundreds of them worldwide, and to be one of the fastest growing franchises. And so I launched this thing in 2008. I launched it in 2009 at the midst, while this horrible recession is happening. And, you hear about people losing their homes, their businesses, their jobs, banks are shutting down, the governments, lost all control over the economy. And here I'm trying to launch a franchise without ever borrowing money from a bank and just coming out of pocket.
So and, perfect yeah. timing, right?
Yeah, exactly. The timing could not be better. Exactly. So as we're filming one of the content videos, Rob says, hey, I need to change out a battery. So we're taking a little break. And he goes, how are you able to film these things? Because we're filming 15 of them in one day. I like to batch process everything I do. Excuse me. And he said, how is it that you have so much passion, so much enthusiasm? You have such a conviction that this Fit Body Bootcamp thing is going to work. I said, well, why wouldn't it work? He goes, we're in the midst of an economy crash. This is worse. Some say it's worse than the Great Depression. We've got double-digit unemployment. And he was rattling off everything he hears in the news. Now, I hear that stuff too. But none of that is as bad as where I come from, which is a communist country, Armenia, at the time under Soviet rule. My dad was a member of the Communist Party. We escaped in 1980 to come to the United States. And when you compare the life that we have here, even in the depths of what many call a world-renowned recession that we had, it doesn't hold a candle to how life is, the oppression, the lost opportunities, the failed opportunities, the lack of opportunities that one has in a communist country. And so to me, I have contrast. And so the way I look at it is no matter how bad things get here in the United States or any westernized, free, civilized country, it's never as bad as what I experienced there. Now, when we escaped Armenia and came to the United States as political refugees, for the first year or so, it was very touch and go. We were poor and broke. My father would literally find grocery stores where they were throwing out, produce and dairy and bread into the dumpsters, and he would lift me up into the back of these dumpsters, and I'd dive in and I'd start looking for food that was expired, but it wasn't necessarily bad. Or maybe it was moldy, but my mom could pick off the mold from the bread and the cheese and we would eat it. So I was literally the one bringing home the bacon, if you will, while my parents and my older brother and sister were each working multiple jobs, washing dishes at a pizzeria, working at a car wash, and then delivering newspapers in the middle of the night. All three of them had, that gig going on. And so I had, as a six-year-old kid, I had my role. My role was to, get lifted in the back of the dumpsters at the end of the night and fish out our food for the next day. And so having experienced all that, having been so poor and broke, and then years later, in my 20s, having tried to launch a fitness business, and in one of them, my supplement business, in 1998, I tried launching an online supplement business. There was no Google, there was no search engine optimization. We didn't know much about copywriting back then. Supplements were expiring left and right. So I was buying them. I'd sell maybe 1/10 of them, and the rest we'd have to throw away. And it didn't take long for me to have my credit cards maxed out. And got evicted out of my apartment because I used my rent money for the last batch of supplements. And at the end of the day, I found myself living in the back of a Toyota pickup, in my Toyota pickup. Now, I was a personal trainer at the time as well, Andrew. And so I had the gym. It was a big box gym, an LA Fitness in San Diego that I got to shower in and everything. So it wasn't like I was the homeless guy under a bridge. But when you spend almost 96 days in the back of a pickup truck and you don't really have a mailing address, and the only things I carried around with me were two milk crates of shit that I had, it's a very humbling experience. But
sorry to interrupt, but so what's going through your head at that time? What keeps you going in moments like that?
What keeps me going is I constantly was able to tell myself, and even these days when things are bad, because today I have first world problems. As a global franchise, we are governed by the Federal Trade Commission. And, when you have the Federal Trade Commission reaching out to you and asking you to do 11 audits a year, which is normal for a franchise, it's daunting. But then you go, I've experienced worse. And so in that time, in the back of the truck, I go, you know, I've experienced worse. I remember not knowing the language, being poor and broke, my father and mom crying every night, thinking they made the wrong decision. My older siblings, scared to death, we're living in someone's spare bedroom, five of us in one bedroom that my dad's paying rent to, and I'm fishing rotten food out of a dumpster. I've had worse. So, man, living out of a Toyota pickup in San Diego, California, still having clients to train, and having the juice bar, you know, store my food, it wasn't so bad, right, compared to what I had. So I realized very quickly that life is all about contrast. And my job now today, because I not only have multiple coaching programs, mastermind programs, this international franchise with nearly 500 locations worldwide. I also do a lot of speaking at events. And people go, are you a motivational speaker? I go, no. Motivation is internal. You've got to come to me with your own motivation and your idea. And I can help you make millions with your product or service by exposing your passion and purpose to the world. But the thing I do is I teach people, I install my immigrant edge inside of everyone who's in an audience that's listening to me so that they can experience that contrast and realize that even in the shittiest of times in our wonderful country here in the United States, we have tremendous opportunity to grow and to add value to society.
Well, that's what I was going to say that I love about your story is that you've always continually grown by always learning, always becoming better at your craft. And your career really saw exponential growth because of it. You went from being a personal trainer, training clients one-on-one, to, like you said, being able to help millions of people transform their bodies. And now you're really the go-to guy in the fitness entrepreneur world. Was this always the plan, or did it just kind of come out of natural progression?
No, you know, it did come out of natural progression. And I guess this would be the first big takeaway of this podcast is for anyone listening is, so many people sit down and they want a whiteboard or blueprint their game plan for the next 10 or 15 years. And they get paralysis by analysis since they don't know what the road ahead holds. If you told me 10 years ago that Bedros, see, I sold my five personal training gyms ultimately and got into coaching and consulting. And I thought that was it. This is my gig. I had no idea I was going to create an international brand that people were going to jump on board with. I had no idea that I'd be coaching and consulting New York Times bestselling authors and TV celebrities, you know, in the fitness world. I had no idea. All of that tends to unfold as you finally put yourself on your path that God or universe or whoever is your higher power has installed this gift within you. You decide to take this path and move forward. As the path continues, the vision becomes clear. You go, oh, I'm not just meant to coach fitness professionals. I actually have this ability to create a brand that people are so committed to that they'll come on board and open up locations worldwide. And you go, holy cow, I actually have this story and this ability to share this story with audiences so that they can install this immigrant edge experience that I've had that's given me an edge that they need to have. And so the path unfolds, but most people tend to want to see the whole path before they take that first step. I say start walking down your path, man, and it will unfold in ways you never thought possible.
That's the thing I've noticed is it's kind of a paradox. It's obviously very good to have a vision and belief in yourself and have high goals. But a lot of the time, like you said, it's paralysis by analysis where it is such a big goal from the beginning. It inspires you, you know, it kind of gives you that external motivation. You know, you talk about it, but internally it's overwhelming because it seems so monumental. And just taking those first steps moving forward is really what you need to do when you start out.
Yeah, exactly right.
And that kind of leads me to my next question. From a lot of your work I've read, you believe coaching through experience, not by theory. You draw all your coaching knowledge and training from your years of in the trenches, trial by fire experience that has enabled you to build your empire.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, with the internet, how easy it is to post something on sale for online, literally within, you know, hours, you can get something up. I've seen a lot of people who really aren't providing true value, and then they're complaining and they're wondering why they're not successful, why they're not making money. So how important do you think it is to learn and really get good at a certain skill, pay your dues, and put in the hard work?
Listen, it is probably the most important thing. It is more important than marketing, more important than selling. Like you said, the problem is with the internet, and Facebook has made it so easy for us to just go, I want to target young men between the ages of 26 and 36, and I want to teach them how to pick up women, or I want to target, women between 32 and 55 and teach them fat loss. And so it's become so easy that we get good at marketing because marketing has become super easy, and we are awful at delivering the promise, which is unfortunate because there's no time than now where bad news spreads fast. I mean, you got Yelp, you got Google local reviews, you got Facebook reviews. I mean, man, Andrew, you screw up on something and people are going to smear your name through the mud. Not to mention you've got the obligation and duty to whoever you took money from to deliver the best possible outcome. So for me, yeah, man, I say if you're going into an industry, how many times do you go on Facebook and you see, sell high ticket coaching programs? And it's like people I've never heard of before. And I'm always skeptical because to me, if I've never heard of you and you're teaching someone to sell high ticket products, I'm not saying that because I've never heard of you that you're a scam, but I might go and ask a few people. I might ask Matt Smith, Craig Ballantyne, Lewis House. I might reach out to a few people. And if they've never heard of you, then maybe you're just a charlatan.
Well, Yeah, it's always weird, especially when you see the success life coaches who have something for sale. You know, you read through their copy, their pitch, and that's their career. It's like, what do you have this to base off of? What experience? Yeah. And especially, with Instagram and social media, you got so many motivational social speakers and they try to create a career out of it, but there's no substance behind that.
Yeah. The people who truly value knowledge and want to receive an outcome, these people actually do the research. They ask around. Like, I had no idea that Lewis House knew of me. One day he reaches out to me and he goes, "Hey, I talked to 6 people. You have to come and do my podcast." I was like, "Holy shit, dude, I listened to your podcast. It'd be an honor." Right. Yeah. The other day, Craig Ballantyne introduces me to Tucker Max, and Tucker's like, "Wow. Hey, I want you to help me set up my ambassador program." And so I was on the phone with him, helping him with that. And he goes, "I talked to like 4 people about you and they all speak highly of you." So your reputation and your track record is a must. And the people who are going to spend, $30,000 with me for a day, these people ask around. The problem is what we see being sold these days online as expert advice is being sold for so cheap. People go looking for a price break instead of the value they're going to get by paying a premium. And I read this quote the other day, and you'll appreciate this. It says, if you think hiring a professional is expensive, wait till you hire an amateur. And I was like, amen.
Yeah, that is exactly. That is great. Speaking of your network and the people and who know you, it's really amazing. If you guys go and look at Bader's website, any social media of his, it's incredible how far your network stretches. What would you say is responsible for building this enormous network of yours?
I don't know. This is going to be a stupid answer, probably, but I just keep my head down and I work. And I work.
No, that's the best answer you could possibly give.
That's it. It's a track record, man. It's a track record. And before you know it, someone comes up to Joe Polish and goes, "Hey, who's the guy in fitness if I want to just penetrate that industry and blow it up?" And Joe goes, does a text introduction to Peter Diamantes or whoever. And it's like, holy shit, man, I read your book, Peter, and I'm being texted. And so maybe I'm still naive. I just think I have my head down and I work in this tiny little industry of ours. But people who are watching, and that's what I've learned, people are always watching, and those people who are watching are connectors. Like Joe Polish is a connector. Craig Ballantyne is a connector. Lewis House is a connector. And they're watching, and sooner or later, someone's going to need your service. And if you've been doing your job right, you've been plowing, you've got a reputation and a track record, your name is going to come up as the expert in that industry and no one else's.
And I just want to stress to our listeners how important that is what Bader's just said. Put in the hard work. And especially our audience is definitely skewed younger, and not necessarily my audience, but our generation, people don't want to hear that. They want to hear, especially when it comes to networking, like, oh, what do I put on my LinkedIn profile? What do I tweet? What do I put on Facebook? And I just don't think anything replaces bringing value to someone. And that's what people look for in, quote unquote, their network is, do these people bring value to my life, my business, and not just my business, but me personally and the quality of my own life?
Yeah, that's exactly it. I mean, Craig Ballantyne, who started off as a coaching client of mine, We later became business partners and best friends. We're like brothers now. Just 2 months ago, you know, dropped 30 grand for a day and bought coaching from me again. And it's because he's seen the track record. The first time he coached with me, he's seen what I've done with our coaching clients that we have together. And now that he's got his perfect day formula, it's a whole new business model that we're setting up for him, his perfect life coaching program. You know, he knows what I can do. Now, I'm not going to let him down. And by not letting him down, he refers other people to me. And these other people have such respect for him that they don't question my price. They don't question my ability. They just go, here's what I want to achieve. Can you do it? And they know that if I say yes or no, it's the truth. I don't say, they know it's not going to be a yes because I want their 30 grand for that day. That it's a yes because you come referred by my best friend and brother who stays at my house. And to me, man, that is gold. My reputation, my track record is gold.
That absolutely is. What's the saying that it takes a lifetime to build a reputation, but a second to destroy it?
Yes, sir, especially these days.
Yeah. And it also goes to me to say what you're talking about. Craig, you know, your best friend still paying you $30,000 for your time. And what I've noticed from my own career and learning my different skills is that when you do put money into something, it gives you a sense of urgency and something you're not going to waste it. And then from a business standpoint, if you're taking money from someone, like you said, you have an obligation to them.
Yeah.
It is your obligation to provide them value. So yeah. The majority of your work these days now, like you said, revolves more around teaching and teaching people to build businesses, become successful. And, you know, from the experience I have, I think you would also agree with this, that teaching itself makes you better at what you do. So how does putting on these workshops, these mastermind seminars, make you a better person?
Man, you nailed it. I feel like I get the most out of all the relationships. And I know if anyone hears this, they're going to go, then why am I paying you so much money if you get the most out of it? Because the way I look at it is, I can't come to a mastermind because, you know, Craig and I have a mastermind together called the 100K Info Group. I can't go to a mastermind and teach the stuff I taught 90 days ago because we meet every 90 days. I have to go and teach them stuff. And what I love about the internet is it's evolving so quickly that if you go and teach archaic information, you are done. You are done. And so one, by being a teacher, it forces me to embrace the latest, greatest, newest technologies, medium, platforms. I mean, I am knocking out 2 Facebook broadcasts, live broadcasts a week because I want to expedite my learning curve. Why would I do 1 a week when I can do 2? And as of next week, I'm going to 3 a week. I want to get past the learning curve because I've got a mastermind coming up here in mid-September with that group I just mentioned. And in the first 3 Facebook live broadcasts, I sold nothing. I just built value, goodwill, taught, and said, have a nice day. The last 2, I covertly sold, made offers, and to see the type of conversion we were getting on our sales pages for FitPro Newsletter, which is a software that I have, was through the roof. And it's because it was live, in-person, social interaction. They could ask a question about it, just tell me their objection or whatever condition that they might have. And I could overcome that or let them know that, hey, it is a condition. I can't overcome it. And I think people love to see that transparency. So I had, listen, all my funnels work well. I had no reason to start doing Facebook Live other than I've got to embrace the latest medium and either say it's crap or say, here's how I use it to make money. And then teach it to the people who pay me an obscene amount of money to know what's the best avenue of getting leads and converting them into clients. And so, yeah, because of that, I really truly get the best experiences and lessons because I force myself to always know and learn more, if that makes sense.
Yeah, of course. And speaking of staying with, you know, the technology, what's working, how often do you see big, huge companies that have dominated the industry, big names who get stuck in their ways and then they get passed by?
Yeah, man, you see that often. So many people get stuck in their ways. And, you know, my whole thing is if you're going to open up a brick and mortar, actually, I lie, you can't even do that with a brick and mortar these days. Well, you probably can. You can open up a donut shop, a personal training studio still. We have plenty of Fit Body Bootcamp owners who don't necessarily get super active on social media. Thankfully, we run their social media for them. You know, they build their business off word of mouth, right? Training people, referrals, or, you know, you, someone loves your donut, they're going to go tell others, and you're going to say, hey, you know, send them in, and I'll give them a deal on their first batch of donuts, whatever. But outside of a brick and mortar business, if you are a thought leader, if you're into copywriting, content, authoring something, selling information products, coaching services, you want to be a speaker, you must embrace the most recent mediums that are available in technology. Otherwise, you are left behind. Like, things from 90 days ago are as good as 9 years ago on the on the internet. Yeah.
Yeah, it's insane. And that just goes back to what we talked about before, is always being a student and always keeping your ego in check, because you can always get better no matter who you are, what you've done.
Yeah.
So now I wanted to get into a few rapid fire questions with Bedros Koulian. Sound good, man?
Yes, sir.
Awesome. So first question is, what is the favorite part of your career these days?
Oh, my favorite part is now diving into other industries outside of the fitness world and teaching people who are doing 2, 3, 4 million a year how to scale to 10, 15, 20, effectively take a really successful business and build it into an empire. Part of it is, you know, like any entrepreneur, I love a challenge. And after 20 some odd years in the fitness space, there's not a fitness business that I haven't done personally, from boot camps to one-on-one training to everything in between to online training. I've had my own online training platform for years. And so to be able to take this knowledge and then move it into other industries, man, it's a kick for me. I love it.
Wow, that's awesome. And then my next rapid fire question for you is, what books would you recommend to someone who is struggling to find their path or their calling in life?
Good question. I would probably start with, this is going to be the Lewis House promotion podcast, but truly, it's not like Lewis is paying me to say this, but The School of Greatness and The Big Leap. So, you know, Lewis's book, The School of Greatness, and then The Big Leap by Gay Hendricks, I would say are the two big things. If there was a third book, it would be Cardone's 10X Rule, because if you don't have passion, he will beat you up with that book until he wakes the passion up within you.
I couldn't agree more, especially with the Lewis Howes stuff. He's great. He's one of my favorite guys in the biz right now. And so that kind of leads to my next question is, who's the most inspiring or best live speaker you've ever seen?
Sean Stevenson, man. That guy, not only is he funny, he articulates well. He pokes fun of himself. I mean, the guy's, what, 3 foot tall? He's in a wheelchair. He has a back scratcher to use as to push buttons on elevators. But you look at him and he's larger than life. He doesn't hold his disability as a reason to not succeed. The man said, he's got a thing where he said, you worked with me for 12 hours, 12 fucking hours, and I never want to see you again. I go, Sean, when you said that from stage, are you serious? Like, you work with someone for 12 hours and you just fix their emotional constipation? He goes, yeah, 12 hours. Traditional therapy is bullshit. 12 hours and you're never going to see me again.
Wow.
And if you still have the problem, it's because you didn't follow through on your end. I was like, holy crap. So anyway, he's the most entertaining. He is the most passionate. And there's a guy who, for all intents and purposes, should not be on stage. Should not even be alive. His bones would break when he would sneeze. And he is still trucking along, kicking ass.
That is awesome. And really puts things in perspective for people.
Mm-hmm.
So our final rapid fire question is, I have to ask this, where do you see the fitness, nutrition, health business going in the next 5 to 10 years?
Yeah, that's a really smart question to ask. And I've always been fortunate enough to see where the industry is going and get there before the industry has gotten there. You know, I created High Tech Trainer in 2001. And before the iPhone was ever created, Sprint had something they called the Jukebox. The first app was not, believe it or not, on an iPhone. It was on Sprint, on the Sprint platform. And High Tech Trainer was the first fitness app on the planet. And we
had... Wow, I never knew that.
Yeah. So we had, check this out. We had 250,000 people on the Sprint network, paying $299 a month using HiTech Trainer, my online training software, on their phone. So imagine your old flip phone where you could download workouts and pictures and do them. It wasn't streaming video. It was just, you know, start and end pictures of the workout. But that was the very first app. And I knew that as we were able to start seeing pictures on phones, I knew that I had to take my online personal training software from the internet and pump it into a phone. And so that's what we did. And of course, you know, we ended up selling that platform for millions of dollars years later. But with boot camps, they used to happen in parks, and personal trainers, as you know, you're in the fitness industry. Personal trainers were the mindset that, well, if I really want a business, I'm going to have to do one-on-one personal training and open up a gym, even if it's a 4,000 or 5,000, 6,000 square foot gym. Nothing major. Boot camps are just kind of a passing trend. It's a phase. It's not worth signing a lease for. I'm going to do it in the park at a parking lot. And I saw this model and I said, wait a minute. You know, I see NFL level, Super Bowl level teams being trained by a coach. So if we can train the world's top paid elite athletes in a group, why couldn't we take the average Mrs. Jones, who's got 25 pounds of flub to lose and a lifestyle change to make, and train her in a group? Now, if they've got their L4, L5 fused, I get it. You know, maybe we should do some one-on-one training and there's a lot more specification we need. But if you are otherwise apparently healthy, and so I'd said, hey, you know what? We're not going to, boot camps are not a passing trend. In fact, they are the way of fitness in the future. It makes the product more affordable. It becomes more time convenient. And it becomes finally a scalable business for the personal trainer who burns themselves out just to make $40,000 a year. And so I thought of that in 2006, really started putting the pedal to the metal in 2008. And in 2009, we launched it. And here we are, 2016, with nearly 500 locations on 3 continents and 6 countries. Wow. And so you're asking where the industry is going. And where it's going now is into micro niches. You know, people don't want to know that you're a generalist. They want to know that you are a specialist at a thing. So Fit Body Bootcamp, for example, we do 30-minute fat loss workouts for women. That's it. It's 30-minute afterburn fat loss workouts for women. We know who our market is and we know what we offer. You want performance? Go to CrossFit. And kudos to CrossFit. They specialize in one thing and they do their one thing better than anybody else.
I was just going to say that what they've done in the past 5 years is incredible.
Huge, huge. They've created a language, man. So we do the one thing, which is fat loss afterburn workouts, 30 minutes for women. They do performance programs for what should have been weekend warriors, and now they can go and do CrossFit games. And so as you see the Spartan races coming up, Spartan races are crushing mud runs because they are more definitive and they've identified their niche market. They identified their customer. They know who to polarize. And so it's going into specificity. The tighter you can identify who it is that you serve and how it is that you serve them, the better you're going to be. So in the future, I wouldn't be surprised if we have, that's why, by the way, online personal training, there's coaches that only deliver online training workouts. And follow up with you via Skype, and they're FaceTiming you, et cetera. They specialize in that one thing. And so the more you can specialize, the more you can monetize.
The thing about specialization too, as you've seen with your boot camps, with CrossFit, with Spartan races, is they give people this really unique sense of community. And, you know, they make people feel special because they're part of this group that's greater than themselves and people who are working together and who share this passion.
That's exactly it. And we all want to belong to a community. And, you know, let's face it, if you're the average Mrs. Jones or whoever, you walk into a big box gym, they're not going to follow up with you to see if you showed up yesterday and tomorrow and the next day. You know, you go into a place like, let's say, CrossFit or Fit Body Bootcamp or any kind of like a personal training gym where the trainer actually gives a shit, they're going to text you. They're going to follow up. They're going to make you feel guilty until you come in. And people want that. They want the accountability. They want the experience of people knowing them by first name, and they want the community that ends up being a byproduct of all of that.
That is great. And so our final question that we ask every guest on the show, Bedros Koulian, what is the one thing you challenge our listeners to change or do in their lives to become a champion?
Yeah. I'm going to tell you that one thing is do not hit the snooze button in the mornings. And the reason for that is I'm a believer, and some people might say I'm a nut. I'm a believer that if you hit snooze first thing in the morning just to get an extra 8 minutes of sleep, which I believe it's either 8 or 9 minutes that the iPhone gives you, if you hit snooze, you really are telling the universe, you're telling your subconscious that 8 more minutes of interrupted sleep has greater value than my purpose and my passion and my need to dominate my path. And that sets the tone for the rest of that day. Now, some people might say, well, you know, big deal. It's just for that day. Well, you do it that day, you're going to do it tomorrow. And that becomes a habit. And habits become rituals, and rituals lead to either success or poverty.
Absolutely. That the morning is essential. And you can tell that you and Craig Ballantyne are good friends.
Yeah. He's been a huge influence in my life in that way.
Oh, yeah. Both you two are just amazing. So where can our listeners find all your work and your social media accounts, anything that you want to plug?
Yeah. So the best place to go is to BedrosKulian.com, you know, my first name, last name.com. And then, of course, on Facebook, Facebook.com/BedrosKulian. Otherwise, if it's fitness professionals listening to this, they're going to want to go to PT Power, as in personal trainer, ptpower.com. And between those three platforms, if you can't get a hold of me, then I don't deserve to be in business.
And I will have that all in the show notes for you guys. Thank you so much for being on the show today, Bedros.
Thank you so much, Andrew. It was a wonderful experience.
And that was my interview with Bedros Kulian. I really can't thank Bedros enough. That was surreal for me getting to interview him. As you heard, his time is very valuable. This was such a great experience, and I hope you enjoyed the show as well. You can find all the show notes and resources discussed today, including where to find all of Bedros' work, at www.firstfinisher.com. Once again, this podcast was brought to you by First Finisher and our Total Performance Powder. Remember, special just for podcast listeners, you can receive 15% off your entire order by using the discount code PODCAST15. If you enjoyed the show, please go over to our podcast page on iTunes and leave a 5-star review. These really help our show getting noticed and help us spread our message. Don't forget to subscribe to the show on iTunes so you never miss an update. Thank you so much for listening. I wish you the best in your pursuit of becoming a champion.